CompTIA ITF Plus Complete Training Course. Exam Objective 3.4, Explain Methods of Application Architecture and Delivery Models. Architecture Models. To keep in line with CompTIA's ITF Plus Exam Objective 3.4, this video will cover the 1-tier, 2-tier, 3-tier, and N-tier application architecture models. Now let's start with the simplest model, the 1-tier architecture, and see how the application architecture layers we learned about in the previous video are organized. In a 1-tier architecture, also known as a monolithic architecture, all the components of an application reside on a single machine or system. There is no separation of the presentation layer, application layer, and data layer. Instead, they are all tightly integrated into one unit. To better understand the 1-tier architecture, let's imagine a computer game that runs entirely on your personal computer or workstation. In this scenario, your computer becomes the complete application ecosystem. The game's graphics, sounds, user interface, logic, and data storage are all bundled together and operate within your computer's resources. While this approach is suitable for simple and standalone games, it may encounter challenges when dealing with more complex and larger scale applications. For more extensive applications, modern software design emphasizes breaking down the different layers into separate modules, allowing for better scalability, maintainability, and flexibility. To achieve these benefits, multi-tiered architecture models should be used. So let's try breaking down our 1-tier architecture into a 2-tier architecture. Here the components of an application will be divided into two main parts: the client and the server. In this 2-tier architecture model, the presentation layer will be handled by the client side of the application. As for the application layer and the data layer, they will be handled by the server side of the application. And what do you know? I have another analogy for you. For this 2-tier architecture scenario, picture a fast food restaurant with a cashier at the counter and a kitchen in the back. The cashier takes your order and communicates directly with the kitchen to prepare your food. This parallels our 2-tier architecture. The client handling the presentation layer is our cashier, and the server handling our application layer and data layer is our kitchen. While this model is an improvement over the 1-tier architecture, it can still become challenging to maintain as the application grows. So let's keep going and break down our 2-tier architecture into a 3-tier architecture. In a 3-tier architecture, all three application architecture layers are broken into separate components. Again, we will have a client and a server, but the data layer will now be handled by a distinct database component. In this 3-tier architecture model, the presentation layer will be handled by the client, the application layer will be handled by the application server, and the data layer will be handled by a separate database server. This model allows for better scalability, as each layer can be managed separately, making it easier to add or modify components without affecting the others. Lastly, we have the N-tier architecture. In the N-tier architecture, the N is meant to represent any number of tiers. Imagine a large corporation with several departments. Each department has its specific tasks, and they collaborate when needed. In an N-tier architecture, we have multiple layers, each with a specific role and responsibility. These tiers can range from three to many, depending on the complexity of the application. This model provides the highest level of flexibility, making it ideal for complex applications. So, to summarize, application architecture models are like building your application with Lego blocks. You can start simple with a 1-tier, add more features with 2-tiers, get even fancier with 3-tiers, or go full-on architect mode with N-tiers. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more great content.